A Shot in the Dark. Hector Ho Munro is the author of this story, A Shot in the Dark. He was born on 18th December 1870. He is better known by his pen name Saki and also frequently as H.H. Munro. He was a very intelligent British writer, very mischievous. He is considered as a master of the short story and often compared to O. Henry. Besides his short stories, he wrote a full-length play, The Washed Pot. The main characters in this story are Philip Sletherby. He is a man who wishes to become a politician. Then Mrs. Salpen Jago. She is a very rich and influential lady who is in the high position. Bertie, son of Mrs. Salpen Jago. Then Claude People Casey. He is a friend of Philip Sletherby. Briefly, I will explain you about the whole summary of the story, A Shot in the Dark. Philip Sletherby wishes to become a member of the parliament in the eastern division of the country. The gentleman who is holding the membership at present does not seek re-election, and Sletherby is considered to be his successor by the party. Recently, Sletherby has developed a contact with Mrs. Salpen Jago. She is a very rich lady in the society. She can confirm the nomination of the parliament. Philip Sletherby goes to meet her in her country residence in Bryl Manor. At the station, he meets one of his friends and tells that he is going to spend the weekend with Mrs. Salpen Jago. His only companion inside the carriage was a young man with dark hair and fresh complexion. He was desperately searching for something from his coat pocket. He took out 6 pence again and again and was helplessly looking at it. A cigarette case, matchbox, latchkey, silver pencil case and a railway ticket set aside on the seat beside him. But the man calls him and asks him whether he is going to meet Mrs. Salpen Jago at Bryl Manor. He says he is her second son, Bertie, and he would be there on Monday evening. Then he explains that he has left his purse behind on the table. The purse has his crest on it and 4 quid with it, which would meet the expenses of this week and weekend stay and fishing in Broadway. So he asks Sletherby to lend him £3. He too willingly accepts to help him. Then he inquires about his crest and Bertie replies that it is a demi lion holding a crosslet in its paw. Sletherby remembers correctly that it was a greyhound current on his mother's notepaper. Bertie promptly replies that it is the logo, it is the Jago crest, while demi lion is the Salpen crest. Slowly, suspicion crept into the mind of Sletherby. To clear it away, he further inquires about his mother's appearance so that he could identify her easily at the station. Bertie replies that this mother resembles him with dark brown hair and high color. While getting down in the next station, Bertie asks for his 3 quid, which he had already promised. But Sletherby refuses to pay the money, saying that difference in the symbol of crest shook his promise, and the story about the resemblance of his mother also confirmed his doubt. Actually, he has met her once in the party with the blonde hair. Letterby is all happy and proud about his shrewdness and eagerly awaits the dinner to narrate this interesting story, what had happened in the train, to others. On the contrary, when he was received in the next station, he sees the two crests, both a greyhound and a demi-lion, on the door panel of the car. He comes to know that Mrs. Alpenjago often changes her appearance, and 5 weeks ago she has changed dark brown into blonde. Sletabai is totally shocked and becomes spellbound. Seeing is not everything. So, dear children, appearances are always deceptive. Deceptive means very cheating, it is not real. There are so many truths behind it. Life itself is a thrilling experience and offers you a lot of surprises in its path. The smartness of Slitherby is shattered by such a surprise in this story. Thank you.